Hey friends, I'm Natalie with Autel Robotics. I'll be going over the Follow Autopilot feature for your X-Star Series drone. Follow is one of three autopilot features that comes integrated with the X-Stars.
Follow allows your aircraft to automatically follow your remote controller and mobile device.
When in follow mode, the X-Star will always take the shortest route possible to stay with you, which means it will cut corners to keep up, so just be cautious of any obstacles in the path, such as trees or power lines. You should also note that the X-Star will maintain the altitude you preset in the app unless you use manual inputs to change the altitude during follow. Be aware of this as you're planning your path and make sure you pay special attention to any drastic elevation changes. Let's start by getting ready for flight.
Don't forget to remove that gimbal lock before powering on the drone. Once you've launched the Starlink app, you can access all of the autopilot modes by tapping the fly icon at the top of the left navigation bar. You'll notice the three options under the fly icon are grayed out. This is because we will need to put the X-Star into a hover before unlocking these features.
This ensures that the aircraft is stable and has a strong GPS lock before flying autonomously.
Now that the aircraft is hovering, let's start the follow feature. Remember, altitude is your friend. After selecting follow, you will see a menu that shows the distance your aircraft is from you and options for your home point.
This will determine where the aircraft will fly to when the battery gets low.
The first option is Me. This option will ignore the default home point that was set at takeoff and instead continue to fly to your location when the battery gets low.
Using the Me option works best if you don't plan to end your follow at the location where you started. Another important thing to keep in mind is that when you use the Me option, the X-Star will not prompt you at the low battery level.
Instead, it will allow you to fly to the critical low battery level, at which point the X-Star will automatically land wherever it is when the message is reached.
I'd recommend keeping a close eye on your battery level and landing the X-Star around 25% to ensure plenty of time for a safe landing.
The second option is Home Point. This will send the X-Star back to the default home point, which is where it took off from.
If you're planning a follow mode flight to end at the same location where it started, or if you want to make sure that the X-Star safely lands at the location that it started, regardless of the location of the transmitter, this option will be the best choice. But remember, the X-Star is always calculating the battery level it needs to safely return to its home point, so it will trigger a return to home based off the battery level and distance away from home.
This means that you may see the X-Star try to return to home while following, even if your battery level is at, say, 45%, depending on the distance it is from the home point.
Think about these two options and choose which one works best for you when using the follow feature. I'd also recommend making sure you have a clear understanding of how to reset your home point during flight before you start. Check out the Go Home and Fail Safe video to learn more.
In a pinch, you can always pause autopilot features at any stage using the pause button on your remote controller or through the Starlink app. Doing so will command the drone to stop following and hover in place, and it will also exit the autopilot mode.
The X-Star's max speed in follow mode is 22 miles per hour. The X-Star will do its best to keep up with you, but if you outpace it and get too far away, the X-Star will exit the autopilot mode and go into a hover. To manually adjust the altitude during the follow mode, use the left command stick on the remote controller. When you're finished using the follow feature, you can choose to exit on the follow menu.
As the X-Star begins to follow you, you may need to tilt the camera slightly to frame the shot.
Using these autonomous features can make getting your perfect shot easier, but always make sure you're aware of your surroundings and how these features work to keep you, your aircraft, and others around you safe. Thanks for watching.